Here we'll show the basics of data navigation in IGV. Throughout this tutorial, you can simply watch or open IGV and follow along. After launching IGV, you can select our reference genome from the dropdown on the upper left. Here we'll use Human Genome 19. After selecting a reference genome, it'll appear here in the genome ruler. To add data to your IGV workspace, go to the File menu. Here we'll load some ChIP-seq data from the IGV hosted server. When you load data into IGV, it'll appear in the center of your IGV workspace. The four tracks you see here are bar charts representing histone modification signal intensity. There are a lot of histone modifications in the middle of chromosome 1 across all four samples. To see your data on the whole genome level, select All from the chromosome dropdown, or click the Home button. When we do this, notice that the sequence track shows a bar chart of gene density. If you want to look at a certain chromosome, you can either select it from the chromosome dropdown, or click on it in the genome ruler. Now that we're on the chromosome level, the genome ruler shows a cytoband view of the chromosome, while the sequence track is beginning to show individual genes, though there are too many to make out at this magnification. Now let's say you want to zoom into a particular region. You can either double-click the cytoband, or you can double-click the data tracks. To zoom out again, you can press Alt-click. As you move through the chromosome, a red box on the cytoband will show what region you're looking at. To zoom in even further, you can use the zoom tool in the upper right corner. As you zoom, you'll be able to see individual genes like this one. Here we can see that MetL13 has a 5' UTR, a 3' UTR, 7 introns, and 8 exons. Clicking on a gene in the sequence track will open the NCBI page for that gene in your browser. If you want to see the splice variants of genes, right-click the sequence track and select Expanded. Here we can see that MetL13 has three variants, where the 5' UTRs and first exons are spliced differently. Let's collapse the splice variants for now. If you continue zooming in, you'll eventually reach base pair resolution, where you can see the individual nucleotides. When you're here, the sequence track will show the reference nucleotides. Clicking anywhere on the reference nucleotides will either hide or show the 3-frame amino acid translation. By default, the forward strand of the DNA is shown. Clicking the small arrow to the left will reverse the strand. If you want to jump to a different zoom level, you can click on that level in the zoom tool. If you want to stay at this zoom level and see a different place in the chromosome, you can drag the data tracks or single-click somewhere in the cytoband. And if you have a specific gene in mind, you can enter it in the search box to be brought there. You can also search for a particular region by entering genomic coordinates. If you want to see multiple genes or locations at the same time, simply enter them in the search box separated by a space. Doing this will create separate panels for each feature. You can change the order of the features by clicking and dragging their titles. And you can navigate through them independently. Double-clicking any one of the titles will make that feature fill the window.